Well, welcome everybody out to church this evening.
Yes, sir.
It's about time to get started, and I told Ray when I come in, I said, you know, they're set up, and we're going to have a gospel singing on. You know, there ain't nothing about to, I'm sure they'll stop and be ready for a break or take a breath, and if you got a testimony or not, give it.
Oh, yeah. If we're singing, you're going to testify. You get right up and we'll stop.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll stop, Ray.
So if you got something to say tonight or give a testimony, stand up and give it, you know. But we want to open up prayer tonight. And, most of you can see Mace and Sarah are still not with us, and Mace is, she's still sick, so. She's laying on the floor asleep when I left, so. Let's continue to remember her, and thank God for the great service we had this morning.
Yeah.
You know, it was an awesome service. God was in the middle of us. He sent the Holy Spirit down here to deal with us. You know?
Amen.
We had a lot of prayer. We always make fun of that. People talk about Mount Olive. We pray a lot and eat a lot. So we try to hold up to those two things. But while we get started today tonight, let's bow our heads for a word of prayer. Dad, I don't want to put you on the spot. Open us up in prayer if you don't care.
Heavenly Father, as we come to you, Lord, once again, we're thankful, Father, for this and other opportunity that you allow us to assemble ourselves together, Lord. We pray, Heavenly Father, that your Holy Spirit will come down here tonight, Lord, in a mighty way, Lord. Pray, Lord, that we be obedient to the Spirit, Lord. Let it lead, guide, and direct it. Direct each and every one of us, Lord. Pray, Lord, that you be with the singers as they sing. We pray, Heavenly Father, that you just anoint the songs, Lord, and that they minister to our hearts, Lord. And pray, Heavenly Father, that we will, Lord, be the Christians and servants that you have us to be. Pray, Heavenly Father, for the prayer request that we've heard this day, Lord. We pray, Heavenly Father, that you grant each and every one, Lord, according to your will. Pray, Heavenly Father, for those that are sick and afflicted, battling diseases. We pray, Father, that be your will, Lord, that you reach down a healing hand, Lord, and touch their bodies, Lord, and heal them. Pray, Lord, for the lost, to continue to deal with their hearts, convict them of their sins, Lord. Help them in their lives, Lord, their lost conditions. They need a Savior in their life, Lord. And accept Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, Lord. We do so last and do thank you.
Amen.
We do thank you and praise you, Father, for everything that you've given us, Lord, for the many blessings, Lord, that you bestowed upon us, Lord.
Yes.
Most of all, Lord, we thank you, Lord, for Jesus who come and bled and died on that old rugged cross. Yes. Pay the debt, Lord, that we couldn't pay, Lord. And thank the Lord that one day he spoke to our hearts, Lord.
Amen.
And we accepted
sure.
him as our Savior, Lord. And we praise you, dear Lord, tonight, Lord. You're worthy of our praise, Lord. And we do thank you and praise you, Lord. Pray for our country, Lord. Pray, dear Heavenly Father, that it'll turn back to thee, dear Heavenly Father.
Yes.
It would look to you, dear Heavenly Father, with each and every decision, Lord, and see, dear Heavenly Father, we need to look to you, dear Heavenly Father, for guidance, Lord, and get this country back on track, Lord. Pray, Father, that you'd forgive us when we failed you. Strengthen us in our weakness, and when I fail, bow our unworthy heads. Give you the praise and the glory, for it's in Jesus' name we ask these things. Amen.
Amen. I'm going to turn it over to them. I'm going to let them get started off. If somebody got a testimony while they're getting ready, get right
ahead. If it don't sound right, it's ready for them.
Like you said, if anybody's got a testimony, you just pop right up there and go. Or if somebody needs to come to the altar to talk to God about keys and whatever.
Amen.
We will get right down and pray.
Yeah.
There's plenty of people in this church right here. We'll get down there with you and pray.
Definitely.
You understand, Russ, well, we're trying to do a little part for God here. And we come here to have a good time. So we will. I hope you all will.
I hope you sound a bit better than last time. I know we're a little more organized. Stephanie seemed to that.
Are you sure?
She's our boss.
I'm struggling to get this mic over there. I got it.
It's easy to just pull it towards you. Yeah. It'll fall right out.
It's good to have smart people with me up here.
Yeah, I agree.
Make sure I get it right.
Brother get his cape over ones on.
We're sure happy to have him up here. I love the sound of good banjo.
I don't know him, but I'm taking his ear.
Yeah,
I know. Amen.
Moses led God's children 40 years. He led them through the cold and through the night. Oh, they said, let's turn back. Moses said, keep going. Canaan is just inside. There will be no sorrow there in that tomorrow.
Now don't
where the Son of God is reigning.
At the midnight cry. I just thank God that for all that He's brought me through and helped me through, and I just thank Him for making me feel as good as I do today, and I always thank Him for everything because He has done so much for us, and I thank Him for, this is my niece right here, and she's been in the hospital, and she's doing better. I thank God for her and her husband. I thank God for you guys. I thank the Lord for everything He's done for me. He's been so good to me. And I just thank Him so much because I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for the Lord. And I thank Him so much. And I ask God's interest in your prayers.
Before we sing this song, I just want to say something. This song kind of describes me. I was thinking about it the other day, whenever people were down on the practicing. There's times we do things that we know is wrong, we do it anyway. There's times that, you know, God's there to forgive and forget it. The Bible says when He forgives, He casts in the sea of forgetfulness. He don't remember it anymore.
Right.
So God forgives us, we bring it back up again. He don't know what you're talking about.
That's right.
Amen.
Most people can't get a grasp on that.
Yeah.
And, but you know, God's a forgiving God, and God's a loving God, and I'm thankful for that. Because I've made great mistakes. I mean, I'm so out of one eye. I make a lot of mistakes, but you know what? When it comes down to the brass tacks, I know who my Savior is.
Yeah,
and that's what matters.
Yeah.
But I want y'all to keep me in your prayers. I need them.
That's right. We're hoping you're going to start coming down here with us.
Yeah. You want to tell me this song in this little group?
They've heard it here before, but not with harmony. This is one I wrote. It's called Always. And we'll try to see what we can do with it.
One, two, three.
Put her in drive.
One, two, one.
up everything. God is watching over us and he doesn't miss a thing. There's times we set things we knew we didn't need. Even fought battles while we're sleeping in our dreams.
Fine. Jesus. There's no such thing as the next best thing to a heavenly home of love. There's no such thing as the next best thing to please us. There's no such thing as the next best thing to love.
We're in a dressing room getting ready for the next world, you know.
Yep.
And
I want to be dressed for Jesus when he comes, you know.
Right.
So y'all remember when you're praying.
Bless you, right.
There's a lighthouse on the hillside, over us life's sea. When I'm tossed, it seems out of my life that I might see, and a light that shines in darkness, never save me, lead us on. If it was for that old lighthouse, my ship would sail no more.
Sing that song was right here with us this evening.
And this is the first place that we ever sang.
52 years ago.
Yeah.
Really?
Man.
And that song made an impression then, and it still does, because God's still making impressions. And I was just sitting there thinking as I looked around the room this evening, and all of us gathered here, every one of us has had somebody pray for us.
That's right.
Yeah. If I had a mirror, I could look at it and see, yes, somebody's prayed for me too. And to see you here with us now, it's only God can do that.
Yeah.
And I'm so thankful we pray to a God that listens and can answer prayer.
Man.
Continue to pray for me, that I will be what I should be, and that I would be a light that God wants me to be, to bring others to Him.
Sure. Bless
good testimony.
What did you want me to do?
We're going to get him Michael there in just a minute.
Oh, I was just
going to send some bass with us.
Oh, that gentleman back there? Oh, yeah.
He's a bass
singer. Oh, yeah. What's he going to play back there?
I'm one.
Don't let me mess you up.
We'll get your mic here a little bit. You're going to sing with
him. I take care of all the messing up, all right?
Yeah, we'll take care of him right now.
This is one of my favorite songs. Oh Lord, my God, when I in awesome water consider all the words I have made, Father, see the stars.
Good saints, my soul, my
tonight, because there's never a night that he's not great.
Yeah.
Thank the Lord tonight. There are so many things that we could be praising him for. I just pray that every day of my life that I will never neglect to praise him.
Yeah.
And I pray that God will always get the glory in everything that I do and everything that I say. I pray that I'll always be a vessel that he can work through. And I'm just so thankful that God is doing the things in my life that he's doing. I'm thankful that he's teaching me, he's helping me, he's cleansing me. He's there to be my friend. He's there to be my security, my leader, my everything I need. Our God is so much to us, and he's so good to us. He's so great. And it's just so hard to just stop praising him because of all that he has done for us.
Yeah.
I mean, if you just stop it and think for a second, is there ever a time that God has not helped us? I mean, we're breathing. He breathed air into us.
Yep.
I mean, every day we get up out of our bed and we walk and we can see him. He doesn't promise us tomorrow. Our life is like a vapor.
Yep.
I mean, one day we're going to be faced with him, be face to face with him. And we're going to have so many things to be thankful for. And we're going to have so many things to praise him for. And I just can't even imagine what that's going to be like. But tonight, thank you for reminding me how great he is.
Amen.
You know, really and truly, there's nothing no greater than what God is.
That's right.
Just think about that song right there he was singing. Used to sing it in church. Don't know how many of y'all know Boo Mullins. Me and him used to sing it in church down at Alpha together. You know, he'd done gone on ahead of us.
Yeah.
Be with the Lord. One day it will have be with him again. But God has been so great in my life. Brought me through wrecks, through the army, these coal mines, lots of hurts and bangs and stuff. Some car wrecks that some people get killed in, their vehicle wouldn't be in worse shape than some I wrecked in. And I got to give God the credit for it. Mm-hmm. But you know, one of the most greatest things he done besides the greatest thing when he saved me.
Amen.
All right. But the other greatest thing was 2015, I wrecked a four-wheeler. Broke my back and rib and stuff, still working in coal mines. A couple knocks on the back of my head, blacked my eyes. But I had cancer in my left kidney, and I didn't even know it. And that's why God let me wreck that four-wheel. That thing rolled clear back over top of me. I mean, literally rolled over me. And then it took him, chased my son down the hill behind him. He got off of it. But I couldn't, but if it hadn't been for that, 2016, when they took my kidney up there in Virginia, they told me it's the type of cancer that would have been no cure or no treatment for if it had got out. And it was contained in inside my kidney. Well, look at me now. I'm cancer free 100%. Each year they test me once a year and see if it's been recurring. But they haven't been. I give God all the credit. And I tell it everywhere I go.
Mm-hmm.
Probably told up here, y'all might get tired of hearing it, but I'll tell you what, I'll keep right on saying it.
Yeah.
You know, I think about how some people plays with God. We need to serve God daily as if he's coming back today.
Amen.
Not next week, not next year, today. You know, I get out, I've been saved since 1980. I don't judge nobody, can't judge nobody, but I can be a fruit examiner. When I see people out there who are supposed to be Christians and among the sinners out there, and hear some of the sinners say, well, that person makes a heaven, I will, and they haven't been saved. You know, I don't want nobody to talk about my life like that.
Mm-hmm.
I want them to say, Brother Junior's life, if I want to make it to heaven, I better start serving like he's doing.
That's
get
right.
saved like he did.
Right.
You know, when God saved me, he didn't play around with me. He saved me all the way.
Yep.
And I check and examine my own life. I can't examine other people's life. I just examine mine.
Yep.
And nobody can't make it to heaven for me. I can't make it to heaven for somebody else. Each one of us got to make it on what God wants us to do.
Amen.
And you know, I know a lot of people talks about the Bible says work out your own salvation. Well, that don't mean you just pick and choose what you want. And your salvation, you got to be the one to work it out between you and God, and it's got to be on his terms, not your terms.
Right.
So many people try to make it on their terms, but unless you take and work on God's terms, you can't make it.
Amen.
Bible says, the chosen few, and I believe, you know, it ain't gonna be just a few, there's gonna be a bunch there for us to go. But then there's gonna be some let down. Love each and every one, and enjoy y'all singing there.
Thanks,
Jerry.
Come on up here, Daryl. I got your microphone already hooked up for you,
buddy. Oh, no, I better not try to mess you all up.
No, come on. You can't mess us up. We can do that all by ourselves.
This is slow. I know you know
them. You know that next parade, next four.
Come on.
I don't think he's taking no for an answer.
I don't know your songs.
When he was on the cross, you know that. We're going to be singing that.
This is an old one without him. I know you know that.
That's what I told you.
You are welcome to come with your answer.
Come on. Oh.
Yes.
I make them look good anyway.
That's right. I was going to suggest just come up here and hold the mic and lick turkey.
Let me tell you what. I was singing this guy whenever I was just a little fella. I mean, my dad got us all around the piano when we were just little kids and taught me to sing first tenor. Of course, the rest of them sing all the time.
You know, you were sitting back here looking like a bear up here now.
Take a hammer, you know who I am.
Oh, I know.
Oh, yeah. Well, I guess he's having a good singer, but I guess he was.
I had a lot of hammers up here around.
Yeah. Yes. Most every hammer I've ever lived
in. That's not all we ever sang with them. Right aside toward that for a long time. In fact, I got a tape that's got him on it. I don't play it much anymore.
I don't blame you. No,
he sang a song right there. What was that song?
Metal for Mother.
Yeah, Metal for Mother. I wish you'd sing that. I can sing the bass with that.
I can do that a little bit.
Okay.
So I want to do just a little soft too to show him all three.
Okay, go ahead. I'll make a little bass for you.
Well, we'll do this one first without him.
Okay.
Without him. I don't know. You'll learn when you hear.
Y'all saying now that it's a little bass in me.
All right.
He's already talking a little bass in
without him, I could do nothing.
My Jesus, without
39
Y'all can't let up, I'll be on. That's 90 years old.
But I enjoyed it.
Man.
That's wonderful.
Thank you.
My wife turned 92.
Oh, wow.
Man, bless her.
She's put up with you a long time, ain't she?
Good job.
Thank you.
To me, that's a lady right there.
I always said yes.
Yeah.
You put a lot of miles on.
I just sung like that, right? Boy, how you doing there, bud? If you do, watch that boy went over on the side.
There's a light whistling. There's a light.
Me, may back up there?
Every time I think about that light, it whistles at me.
I'm just kidding you, buddy. Just jump right in and do it.
There's a light in the window. The table's spread in splendor. Someone standing by the open door. I can see Bristol River. Oh, I must be near forever. And I've never been this old sick before. Say a prayer before we sing any more. to pray, and then pop in the next song, just, we need to pray for me. All of a sudden, Ray pops up and says, I think we need to pray before we practice anymore. And you know, he prayed, and after that, it seemed like every song we sing, it just feels such a good anointing.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
And mine was, you know, tonight there have been two or three people that's talked about praising God.
That's right.
The Bible says he inhabits the praises of his people.
Yep.
In other words, he dwells in it. If we're not praising him, how big of a place and habitation are we giving him? Something to think about.
Right, man.
So, I always want to say that I'm thankful, you know, and I praise God because I, you know,
sure.
I shouldn't be here either, but
right.
God had other plans.
Yeah.
And I'm glad I'm with these two.
Yeah.
And I know that's part of his plan. Ain't no denying that.
Yeah.
So,
that is true.
Even if Stephanie can't sing, you know. I'm
trying, man. You're teaching me, Joe.
That girl can sing heavenly.
You're sweet.
I'm proud of her.
Well, I'm blessed to be here with these guys. I mean, it's like a little fest up here right now. Do you know the Lord puts you where he wants you to be when he wants you to be there?
He does.
And he certainly has put the three of us together, and I'm so grateful for that. We'd be lost without these two. But most importantly, I'd be lost without the Lord, wouldn't I?
Yeah, amen.
And my son is going through some struggles, and I know I ask you guys to pray, these guys to pray, and I'm sure he brought that up at the church in an unspoken prayer or some such thing, because the Lord's working in him. That's what I want to share with you, is praise the Lord. He's working in him. You know, he's not right now interested in church, he says, even though he was raised in church. And if you brought him up, they'll come back to it. I believe that.
That's right.
And, you know, he seems to think that all Christians don't go through hard times. It's like, man, people go through hard things, whether they're Christian or not, right?
Yep.
We go through hard things, but what's different for us is that the Lord is there.
Oh, yeah.
He's walking with me even when I can't walk, he carries me.
Sure,
when I can't figure out which way to go, he tells me.
Yeah.
I'm so grateful for that.
He will. Glad you still.
I'll help you a little bit.
Thank you.
The Bible says we got to work out our own salvation with fear and trembling.
Yeah.
Not what somebody else does.
Somebody just
right.
Yeah, he loves.
probably the best song I ever wrote. I mean, one of the best anyway.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved the wretch like me. Well, I once was lost, but now
Bobby in, and just, you know, everything just worked out, just went smooth. But it's,
I love the way God's people work together.
Yeah.
You know, you think you have a band here, you wait till we hear heaven. God bless you all for doing what you do. We really appreciate you. Ray, we love you and your family. You doubled the size of our church when you came here. We love you.
I'm a good friend. Yeah,
well, I'm staying to see you.
Bless you.
Bless you, Mom.
Sure.
Thank the Lord for watching over me in the valleys and in the trials. But the reason I want to stand this evening, and it's been 3 weeks since I've been in church, and that evening we had such a good service. Went home and sat down, and my phone rang, and it was my brother, and he said he was sick. And I said, well, sick, like throwing up, but he thought he had a stomach bug, and he would be okay, he thought. So come Monday, I ended up in Charleston with one of my sisters, and so I couldn't get a hold of him. And figured out that, you know, ended up, he had a brain bleed, and we took him to hospital, and, you know, it went downhill from there. But I'm thankful to say he was saved, he was ready to go.
Amen.
But, you know,
Jesus.
If you're not ready this evening, get ready.
Yes.
Because you don't know when your time's coming.
Right.
You know, and when I seen him on Monday, sometimes he knew me, sometimes he didn't. And after Tuesday morning when he had the surgery, I'm really not sure. And me and my sister really, really had a tough day that day. He would ask us and beg us to help him and ask Jesus to help him. And, you know, it was a tough day. But, you know, I know where he's at, and I know he's in a better place than what I am. And I praise Jesus for that. But I'm just here to say, I don't know everybody's hearts here tonight, but if you're not right, get ready.
Amen.
God's coming back. And
I'm
so thankful that my parents years ago taught me that. And you know, I've tried to pass it on. And I'm like Lynn, I want to be a light and let somebody see that I've got something in my life. But I do need y'all's prayers. And please continue to remember Brooke. She's, of course, going to be starting chemo. And we need prayers for her also.
Yeah.
You know, I'm like Teddy. I got to stand up for God and thank Him for everything He's done for me and everything He's going to do for me.
Yeah.
You know, this is my daughter, and she was in the hospital for about a week, and doctors still don't know what's wrong with her, but by golly, I know one person that could take it all. He could touch us. And Brother Adam, I'd like for the church to lay hands on her and pray for her. I just feel like, you know, that's what we need to do.
Yes.
Sorry. Anybody that wants to come, please do.
Yeah, good.
Really, Father, we approach you through the grace once again this evening, dear Lord. We just thank you for the opportunity to be able to come to you tonight, dear Lord. You know, as we think about coming to you in prayer tonight, dear Lord, we come to you for the need here tonight, dear Lord. You know, as we think about maybe the doctors just can't figure it out, things, dear Lord, but it's just like I want to say, we know what it does, dear Lord. We know what it can take it away and clear it, dear Lord. To completely take it away, dear Lord, I just pray that you can be with us. Just come in and touch it, dear Lord. You know this. Each one of your warriors that called me tonight, dear Lord, when we come into that throne room, dear Lord, we can see you there. We know that you're making all things are possible for you, Lord. And we thank you for the church members that know how to use this, dear Lord. And they call upon us, dear Lord, and we can lay hands on it and just to be able to show our faith, dear Lord, with a worldly fashion, dear Lord. But I just pray that you be with each situation, each doctor that they go to, dear Lord, that you give one of them the wisdom or what they need to see, dear Lord, or the scan that they need to do, dear Lord, whatever it may be, and if it be in your will, dear Lord, that you could just take it from one, dear Lord. Pray that you be at this church and all the prayer requests that's here, dear Lord, and we ask all this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you,
Jesus.
You know, the Bible says many are the afflictions of the righteous, but God will deliver them out of them. Can I finish it? God shall deliver them out of them. Some of them? No, he said, God will deliver them out of them all.
Oh.
So we need to put our faith and trust in God. You know, sometimes it's hard. It's hard to do. We've got to be right there with Him. Trust Him.
Amen.
And I'm preaching to myself too, believe me.
And if God's not in your life, you need to make a choice tonight. You're making a choice if you don't take Him in your heart. Yeah. And if He comes back tonight, it's going to be, you know, you're going to wish you had.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. All right, I think we're going to wrap it up here with this last song. We have had a wonderful time tonight.
Amen.
It's always a great time when God's in the midst.
Yes, it is.
This church is quite a blessing.
Over the valley of death, and its glory has never been told. Where the Lamb is the light in the midst of the night, in the beautiful city of gold.
Home awaiting in the sky, Lord, in the sky.
right on each other. I know I had that problem over there.
It's all right. We got him now.
I was standing by my window on a cold and cloudy day when I saw the first good morning. You carried my mother away. Let a circle be unbroken.
Prosecutor about it. I had to talk to him because I was going to have to sign a paper to pay it back, and they were going to tear it down and I was going to pay it back. But I want to thank you all that there's somebody out there that seen my need.
That's right.
And I know it was the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And I know that he has done so much for my family. So just not just me, but for my family. I got one brother that's fighting cancer really bad, and they told him the other day that they're going to have to quit the chemo because it's tearing up his lungs and he can't breathe. He has to have oxygen sometimes up on 5, and I want y'all to pray for him. I know he has given his heart to the Lord and he's ready to go. But you know, he's been fighting his cancer for 2 years now. And it's not just one cancer, it's several. You know, I'd never heard of people getting hit with so many at one time. I had cancer a few years back and the Lord healed me. I don't have any cancer in my body. And I'm proud of that. I'm glad that I can still stand here and praise him.
Yeah.
But my brother, get back to my brothers, my other brother that's still living, I lost my dad and my one brother within 3 months of each other. And I just have two brothers left. And Andy, my brother, Simpson, he's had surgery and he got a new hip. And he is recovering nicely. But y'all remember him in your prayers, because he is a true child of God.
Amen.
He'll tell you in a heartbeat that he knows when the Lord saved him.
Yeah.
And he knows things that I couldn't even begin to speak of. But for my brother Mike, he's a sad person. But he loves the Lord, and he's ready to go, he says, whatever the Lord decides. But they decided not to give him any more chemo, and he's not going to get any more. But I said, told him that I felt like the Lord had brought him through 2 years with chemo. And I feel like with the prayers and stuff that could go up for him, God could heal him completely, bring him back as a new person, and give him the life that he's still young. He's younger than me. I'm the oldest in the family, and I'm the only girl, but I love this mountain, and I love these people here, and I love everybody. I try to love everybody.
Sure.
And do what the Lord expects. But sometimes I'm weak. And sometimes I don't know, but I don't know why. All night the devil's been telling me not to get up here and make, and everybody make fun of me. But I don't care. The Lord is my shepherd.
Amen.
And Jesus is going to see us all soon.
Amen.
Yeah.
And I want him to recognize me when he comes.
Amen. 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 Amen.
That's right.
You just gave him a black eye.
Thank you.
Clarence and Ann lived right down here at the holler on the holler in the waste when he to get off the hill here. Well, my German lived right up past him, and he pastored this church back in 1972. And Clarence and me, and Clarence and Ann and Denver, my other brother, we started singing a little bit around here. We didn't know what we was doing. Clarence did, and him and Ann, but Daryl and Denver didn't. And so we sang a little bit, and then Clarence's buddy came in here from Virginia, he went to school with. Gary Baker had one of the highest, best, clear singers from the voice that I've heard in a long time. And so he got off of us, you know, and he called me and said, Gary's coming back here. And he said, I want to get him to sing the high part that Ann's just played the piano. I said, that's all right with me. Well, in Denver, he got put on night shift down that hall. He can't sing. I was singing a little bit of the lead part, low. And he said, would you want to sing the bass? I said, well, I'll try. So we started practicing a little bit, and we was doing pretty good, but we didn't know what we was doing. When we were driving by over 80, we were practicing, so they got a hold of Clarence and said, how about come out of church singing? Clarence, we're not ready for it to go out and sing yet. He said, you're ready for my church.
Right.
So we come up here and tried to sing. That's the first sing we ever had. Clarence and Ann were the only two Christian people in the group. Ed Baker came along, Gary Baker and me. He was a bunch of devils. And I always did think after that, down through the years, Clarence had something in the back of his mind. He thought, boy, I get them out to singing and get around the churches and the Lord would get on them. And it did. It happened one at a time. And we just kept going. And I tell you what, we've seen a lot of people change their life
in
the time that we were singing. And we went all over the country singing. Clarence didn't like to go too much, but when he didn't go, Gary Baker and Ann, she'd jump in and sing his part. We just kept going. And so I tell you what, later on, they kept dying off, you know, still going. And I thought, you know, it just how nice and wonderful that was if we came along that way. I don't know as hungry as I was. I don't know what hungry truck driver. And I don't know.
You're still
hungry. Well, yeah, still hungry. But I had to quit driving the truck. The last one to grow about 80. Yeah. And then he told me the insurance wouldn't cover me. But anyway, I tell you what, it's just been a blessing to see people and to do what we do. And to know the Lord in their own heart. Because that's what makes the difference, you know. And after we started changing our lives over, it made a lot of difference singing to people. Back then, it seemed like they could feel it. Even Ray came along and sang with us for a while. And I tell you what, it just has been wonderful. Now, what was going to say?
Well, I don't know.
I thought somebody had...
How long is Brighter Side together?
Huh?
How long is Brighter Side together? How many years?
52 years. And
wow.
I'm the only one that's left. And
you're still singing?
Yeah, I'm still singing once in a while. Got old, they don't have us out too much. They don't blow the cookies too much.
Let me tell you, I love this song. I'm just a little boy. I used to look up to him. And old Virgil, you remember Virgil?
Oh, well, he goes once in a while. Most of the time now, yeah, he's still around.
Yeah,
but he, most of the time he has to stay with his wife over at Newton. He can't get out.
But Virgil Parsons is one of the best tenor singers, I mean natural tenor singers, ever.
Yeah, he came along and...
He used to be my idol, let's put it that way, when I was singing tenor.
Well, he quit the Cowboymen in the early 80s. Yeah. About 82, I think, or right in there, he started singing part-time with us.
Yeah.
He fell in for Clarence one weekend, next weekend Clarence was off. Same, he filled in for Gary. Gary was having a problem. And he's been with us ever since. And he still is a member of the group. And he'll go when he can. And we sang over to Clay High School here about a month ago. And baritone singer couldn't make it, so we went over and Virgil came with Tom. Got up on the stage and was going to sing one song. And he stood up and sang Ben's part all the same with time we say, you know. So he's
And for those of you who don't know, Virgil, he had a stroke, didn't
he? Yeah, he had a stroke.
He still gets up and sings the gospel.
Yeah.
That's saying something right there.
You know, when Daryl was talking about coming up with the Brighter Side, you all heard us talk about times where we would have those sings here at the church, and we'd have
so many people packed up here, and the windows would be open, and people would be outside looking in the windows just to come and praise the Lord and song.
We were here one time, and Monk Taylor brought this group in down to Ohio.
Yeah.
And I mean, these people standing all the way around these windows. And we did that a whole lot, you know.
Benny Fitzwater was one of the ones that came and was standing outside. Yeah. I remember that.
Yeah, what was that lady on this thing?
Old Rugged Cross.
Oh, yeah.
Old Rugged Cross. Let's try that.
Give me a key.
Then we'll let this fellow get up here.
Remember
the
key?
Old Rugged Cross. You know, don't you?
Remember the key here?
Remember this couple of kids.
I don't know, he's leaving.
No, I ain't.
I'm getting far away. Put an old rugged cross.
All right, you'll help me then.
We'll help you.
Yeah, put an R and all.
R?
Yes.
We all up. Let's try G to it. All the
hills. All the hills. You better leave the same. Same thing.
All the hills right there.
All the hills.
Yeah, you love me. I'm not a bass singer.
Yeah.
Thank you.
I guess it's your turn, my brother.
Well, Mom and Dad, you gonna come and sing? Well, while they're coming, God put one verse of scripture on my mind because I told Ray tonight, I said, you all got it. I said, where are we called you here to sing? So let's sing. You know, usually you put a time limit on something or whatever. And I thought it funny when I got back here, I happened to pick my phone up, Sarah texted me, and Ray told me, he said, what do you think, about an hour? We're 2 hours in now, so I always tell them, let God lead. Yeah. You know, we let God lead the service this morning and see what we got out of it. I mean, we had a good service this morning. We've had a good service tonight. Yeah. You know, and it's Bo was talking about Dad's song and he always sings, and if you haven't ever heard it, you know, listen to the words of it. You know, Dad reads that story as Mom sings that little song behind him, but
yes.
Listen to the words of that story, and I'm going to read you this one verse. Why God put this on my mind, well, I know he did because somebody needs to hear it. You know, it comes out of John chapter 4 where Jesus runs into the woman at the well. Very familiar verse. If you've been to church, you've heard about the woman at the well. You know, it's very thing. But I picked out verse 10. It caught my attention, which is where Jesus answered her back. And Jesus answered and said unto her, if thou knewest the gift of God, and who it is that saith to thee, give me to drink, thou wouldst have asked of him, and he would have given thee living water. Yeah. And if you don't know who that is, or you don't know about that living water, you've never got that drink of that. Tonight's the night to get it. You've heard that all night. Somebody has said, if you don't know the Lord Jesus Christ, tonight's the night. And Mom, Dad, you want to come on up. You know, as they're singing that song, I would get up here and pray with you. Yeah. There's all kinds of people up and down these aisles. If you know somebody, you feel more comfortable with them. You know they're safe. You know they know how to lead you to the Lord. Pick them up. Probably anybody sitting in here tonight, they're here. And if they know that you're unsaved and you don't know the Lord Jesus Christ, that's what they're here tonight for. They want to spread the love of Jesus Christ. Listen to the words that we'll let Mom and Dad close us out tonight. Listen to the words of that song as they sing.
I'll tell you what, I certainly enjoyed this.
Amen. Yeah.
I want to tell you that. And another thing, this is one time that they didn't sing the best for last. We're not. That's a hard act to follow on the church tonight. We do try to, like I said many times, we just like to make a joyful noise unto the Lord. The Bible says that. And, you know, we don't claim to be no singers or anything, but we do like to make a noise. And it's just, you know, you just listen to the words of this as I read it, and she sings this song, and I hope that the Lord speaks to your heart here tonight. If you don't know Jesus as your Savior,
man,
I hope that he speaks to you through this. He tugs at my heart every time I even read it myself. He tugs at my heart. And sometimes I want to cry before I even get through it. And the Lord's help will make it.
I've wandered far away from God. Now I'm coming home.
Amen. And just close your revival. And if you can get Western City, when he stepped on a train on his way home and found himself seated next to a young fellow, nothing better to do. He tried to start a conversation with him about the weather and just things in general. And he noticed that he didn't receive an answer from him. And he turned to the young man and saw tears streaming down his cheeks. He told him then, son, I'm a preacher. Well, I'm a minister. I'll be glad to help you any way I can. The young man threw his tears and began to tell this story. Preacher, I got so mean at home that my mom and dad couldn't do anything with me. But one day, I even went as far as to strike my father with my fist. And he told me then, son, we're going to ask you to leave home. But we can't do anything with you, or you're breaking your mama's heart. Preacher, I've wandered all over this country for the past 2 years. And about 3 weeks ago, I gave my heart and life to Jesus. And I wrote my mom and dad a letter, and I told them I'd be on this train.
I told them I was coming home. The preacher told him, son, that's all well and good. But how do you know that you're really well? How do you know that everything's going to be all right at home? The preacher. How do you know that everything's going to be all right at home? But he said, preacher, we've lived on these old railroad tracks all my life in a little white house. Now behind that house is a great big apple tree. And I wrote to my dad and told him, if I was welcome home, if everything was all right, just have that. Go out back and hang a white rag right at the top of that old apple tree. And I can see it from the train. Then I'd know that everything would be all right. Preacher, we're almost home. We're almost home. Would you look out the window and tell me what you see? I want to go home so bad that I'm afraid that that white rag won't be at the top of that apple tree. Preacher dust from the wind of the train. It was a great big grin on his face. He said, son, you don't have a thing to worry about. Well, that old apple tree looks like it's in full blossom. That's all I can see hanging in it from one end to the other in white rags. And I see that gray-haired mama and daddy standing there waving a big white bed sheet saying, come on home, son. Come on home. And you know, it's no matter what we've done in and with us, life. How mean we've been. All we've got to do is ask Jesus to forgive us of our sins and be a welcome all home again.
About 5 seconds before that, God told me, he said, you're going to call the church up to pray. He said, call them to the altar to pray. And 5 seconds later, a woman gets up and testifies, and she said, she starts telling the story. And I told the church one night, I said, take your most important prayer that you have, that one most important prayer, come and pray about it. And that's exactly what she said. And she said at the end of her testimony, she said, if God ever tells you to do that again, do it. She said, because we've seen too many things answered. Laura got up and sang a song, Stephanie said. She got up in the middle of the song and she said, if you got something to pray about, go and pray about it. The devil tried to stop me twice from doing what God was telling me to do. But I still got up behind the podium this morning. I said, come on, church, let's pray. And we went to prayer. That's what he told me to do. That's what we done. We had a great service, and you know, it followed right along the front. And that's it. And if you don't know Jesus tonight, fine. If there's somebody in your life that doesn't know Jesus, go tell them about it. I told a little story about laying treasures up in heaven. It stood out to me so much this weekend.
Yeah.
And we know what God Jesus was telling us in the Bible there when he was talking about laying treasures up in heaven. It wasn't earthly things, but I told the story. He revealed something to me about laying a treasure up that I could. If I could go tell my family member and I can give them a safe, I can take that treasure to heaven with me. Each and every person that we get saved and we tell about Jesus Christ, we can take them to heaven with us. We can take that treasure with us. So when you think about laying those treasures up, maybe God's got somebody on your mind, maybe just a phone call tonight, or write a letter, or whatever it may be. Go and tell them about Jesus. We want to let our light shine down on so bright that people's got to put shades in their windows when they go back. We want it to be bright. I pray for this church every time I pray. I believe it's my job to do that. But every time I call on the Lord, Matt always mentioned it. And I believe that's why he keeps his hanging on us. If you're visitors, remember our church. Remember me that I can lead it in the way that I need to lead it. I can do my best. I don't know how many kids we got here tonight. If we got any, I think we got any besides Briar and Gavin. We let the kids dismiss us. In case you ain't been here, we stand up and praise the Lord for your time. Because we is tonight. Sign-up sheet for a Valentine's Day dinner. If you want to come and be with us, sign up back there. The date's February the 10th at 6 o'clock. That's Saturday night. You just sign your name up, food provided, the kids serve. It's all part of the kids serving thing. But if you'd like to, sign your name up back there.
Hey, she don't forget about that.